Well, praise God, praise God, you lovely people on YouTube and on Facebook and to the whole wide world. I love you guys, and I mean that out of the depths of my heart. Hey, listen, I first want to give a shout out to the people that's under that. I watched this morning that earthquake where thousands of people and them little babies, and they're pulling them babies out, and people holding on to people's hands and up under bricks that I can't even imagine that. And that hit my heart this morning. I had to get up out of that bed and just get to thinking, the Lord, how blessed we here in South Bend, Indiana, and to whoever city or town that not going through anything, we should have empathy for them people, because they're really going through. That's tough. It's something that you really can't fathom, can't imagine that's happening to them. And just think about how bad that is. Just like when the COVID came, it hit us all, and everybody didn't know what was going on. And this is why I tell everybody, is it okay if I just play fair today? I'm not gonna worry about the scripture. We're not gonna deal with the Bible this morning, if that makes sense. I talked to a big guy, he know what I'm doing. Because you have to start off without the Bible, like we all start off outside our parents taking us to church. We went in a new church. But so since you was introduced to it, that means something. It's deeper than, I hear a lot of people, you remember we used to go to church, we had to be in church all day Sunday, all day on Wednesday, we had to go to choir rehearsal, I was on the usher board, all of that, and that stuff was a seed, and that seed was planted to grow in you to be a good person. Let's start right there. Just a good person. Hey, how you doing? All right, love you too. God bless. Just a good person. No, let me get that door for you. Hey, baby, let me hold your hand because it's slippery right here. Just a good person. What did you cook today, honey? Oh, I made a Salisbury steak, mashed potatoes, green beans, and some cornbread. And then I got a slice of pie for you too. Oh, baby, that's beautiful. I'm going to take me a quick shower and I'm going to come in here and love on you. It's time to be super nice on this beautiful Wednesday. This is Winning Wednesday. Win that love back. You know you haven't kissed your wife in the mouth since y'all, my God. Think about it. When the time have you really gave your wife up? You see how long, that's a long kiss. When have you gave her a long kiss? And looked her in her eyes and said, honey, I love you so much. I appreciate what you do. You know, I tell y'all this all the time. This is how you get that house juicy. When have you looked at your husband and said, man, when this started off, you was old knucklehead. You didn't want to, you was just as stubborn. But you, my God, you did something to me, honey. And I sure appreciate the way you take care of me and the kid. When have you loved on your people that's around you, your circle of people? And this is why I tell people all the time, you got to be in control of your circle of people. Now, what you mean by when I say control, you have to be out front running for Jesus Christ. That's what I mean. You have to be out front running for Jesus Christ. It's just bottom line. You can't do it no other way. And when you be out in front of your group of people, your family members, your friends, your coworkers, the strangers, people you meet in Walmart, Chuck E. Cheese, the hairware store, wherever you go, the barbershop, the salon, the nail place, wherever you go, you're supposed to be a walking church on wheels. Come on, somebody. Telling the goodness of Jesus Christ wherever you go. And if you're not doing that as a Christian, that's probably why you're struggling in a lot of areas. So I didn't want to do no Bible. We ain't doing no scriptures. I wanted to just tell you real, to start off being a good person. Then you find a local church, a local group that's loving on the Lord the right way. Not serving no cup. Oh, this is this great cup. Let's serve the cup. No. cup ain't going to do nothing for you but hold some water. You need to reel. That's Elijah told him. He said, well, I don't know what's wrong with y'all, God, but he ain't showed up. We still been waiting. What, is he on break? Or is he asleep? I like that about Elijah. He went to talking about them fake God. I don't care what God you serving. If it's not G-O-D, that's the wrong God. But listen, this is Winning Wednesday. Win your joy back. My God, I'm going to be working with my son. We're going to be starting doing some new stuff. I'm not big into technology and all of that. I could have cameras and lights and a couch and a studio and all that. But I'm just kicking you from my living room. And we just making it real. That's what I want to do, be real, that you could talk to me or you can actually, well, you can talk to me if you find me. But you can feel that I'm right there in your living room. I'm the street pastor. Come on, somebody. If you don't go to church right now because you ain't dealing with them, some of them fakey people, come on. All Christians is not fakey. There's some good people that's going to church also. Thank God for their fight. But at the same time, there's a lot of people that's going for all the wrong reason. So we got to do some shifting and get the real people in the churches, in the school, in the politics, at your workplace. And that's how we're going to change this. And keep giving God praises regardless of what kind of fight you're in. Just keep fighting. He got victory at the end on this Winning Wednesday. I love you all. Be blessed. Oh! Not that it wasn't on my spirit. One of my pastors that I know, he's my assistant pastor. And the Bible said, what you do secret, God bless you and openly. You don't have to tell all your business. But great friend of mine. And I had just preached it on Monday. You can go to my videos and see that I told you that God is allowing the politics to do whatever they want to. Jeremiah 15, read it for yourself. Relationships gonna be struggling. The devil is attacking relationship politics. And older children, the first children that was born by you, be careful with them children. Love on them, because I'm telling you, the devil is trying to attack our children. All this technology and these TV and everything that's going on, our children are all over the place. So just to my best friend, I love you, you know it. I'm not going to tell his name and all that right now because I didn't really get permission to do that. So I just wanted to let you know, man, I love you. We got your back. And I know you're way in Dallas, but whatever we need to do, we can do it to help you, because you definitely with me when I lost my wife. I sure appreciate you, and we talk about it all the time. I love you. Great friend. And you guys be blessed. Be safe out there. Go to the store and right back home. That's how dangerous it's getting. God bless you all.